But this year, real-life dramas upstaged the movies, and it happened well before O.J. Simpson. Back in January, the country was transfixed when two wealthy young men freely admitted killing their parents in cold blood, and the trial ended in a hung jury. Who could have orchestrated such a thing? Defense attorney Leslie Abramson. Would you defend anyone? Would you defend Charles Manson, Adolf Hitler?
Well, no, I wouldn't defend Adolf Hitler. That's an easy call. Would I have defended Charles Manson? Yes. I mean, I'm a defense attorney. That's what I do.
I'm going to object to that answer, Your Honor. This witness has been trying to do this.
For five long months, Leslie Abramson dominated the sensational Menendez murder trial, captivating as many as she infuriated.
I didn't ask you what you stated yesterday. I'm asking you, when was it?
Fired with moral outrage, she rolled her eyes, tossed her wild yellow hair, and let her fury be known.
You tell me you don't have a right to say, Mom, stuff it!
To disagree with Leslie Abramson is to step into the eye of the storm.
My question is very simple. Are these words here yours, or did Detective Zoller make them up? I'm not asking for your speculation. Well, I'm asking you to say them. So
I understand you're asking me to say them. I don't choose to say them.
At times, it seemed her courtroom conduct itself was on trial.
You tend to shake your head negatively when the court rules against you.
Yes, I do, Your Honor.
And you had better stop doing that, or the court's going to find you in contempt.
Well, the court may be finding me in contempt pretty soon anyway, because I'm finding the court's rulings astonishingly biased.
Are you?
But one man's pit bull is another's protector.
You have called Erik Menendez adorable. You touched his shoulder, patted his hair, and people say, what's her feeling about him? Does she think she's mommy?
Yeah, I think to a large extent I do. I would have been happy to raise Erik Menendez. He wouldn't be in jail right now.
For many, Abramson accomplished the impossible. She humanized two brothers who had masterminded the murder of their wealthy parents behind the gates of their Beverly Hills estate.
My dad had been molesting me.
Abramson saved her client, Erik Menendez, from death row, at least in round one of the court trials, by using a controversial line of reasoning, the abuse excuse defense. It worked.
The court finds that the jury is hopelessly deadlocked and declares a mistrial.
A shocking outcome that left many wondering if having an unhappy childhood meant never having to say you're sorry.
This whole business of abuse excuse, the idea that the victim becomes the accused and the accused becomes the victim, you know, a lot of people are having a hard time handling that.
Well, that's because it's mischaracterized. I mean, we were not saying that because these parents were like nightmare parents, your worst notion of parenting, that they deserve to die or that that's an excuse to kill them. We're saying if you terrify people, they may act out of terror.
You defend primarily murderers.
Right.
Why murderers?
I defend people accused of murder. Why I chose to do murder cases, though, is because it was hard. They were the hardest cases, the toughest cases, and the most meaningful. There was so much tragedy had occurred, and so much was at stake.
How many murder cases have you had?
Oh, gosh. 50?
How many have been found guilty?
Of murder? Of any degree? Three.
She's been married for the last 17 years to Tim Rutten, a writer for the Los Angeles Times. Abramson is now 51 years old and has a grown daughter from a previous marriage. However, smack in the middle of the Menendez trial, she took a day off to adopt a baby boy, now 1 year old.
Don't you think a lot of people would be surprised to see you, you know, like this?
I'm sure a lot of people think I sprung from a test tube, you know.
this woman has maternal feelings?
Yeah, this woman.
This woman picks up a baby?
You know, it's those maternal feelings. My ability, I think, to feel maternal about all sorts of people, to want to take care of them, that I think has partly made me successful in court. I think if you don't care, the jury knows it.
There really is good and evil in this world. There really is.
But as a jury of 12 learned this year from Leslie Abramson, it's sometimes hard to know which is which. Next up for Abramson, her memoirs. And of course, the retrial of Erik Menendez, probably in the spring of 95. By then, we will know if the Dallas Cowboys football team can do it again.